Hello friends, welcome to Renu's Englishpedia for class 12. Today we are going to do the chapter On the Face of It from the book Vistas. The author of this story is Suzanne Hill Dave. She was born on February 5th, 1942 in England. Professionally, she is a British author and is famous for her work I Am the King of the Castle, which received the Somerset Maugham Award. In order to understand the story, we must first understand its title, On the Face of It, which is an idiom. It is used when describing the way a situation appears while allowing for the possibility that things may be different. The main characters of the story are Derry, who is a teenage boy, and Mr. Lamb. Derry is defined as a boy who has an acid burn on his face, and Mr. Lamb has a tin leg. Both of them have been isolated due to their physical imperfections. But what is important is how they are as a person and the positive outlook they must have in their lives. This play emphasizes on the fact that what we think of ourselves and how we improve our perception or observation is more important than an outsider's judgment of us. The most important theme of this chapter is the tendency of society to alienate and isolate physically disabled people. The related themes are the anger of a teenager when his face is marked by severe burn marks. This results in rejection of the world, including his family and most importantly his mother, and gives rise to his desire for isolation. Another related theme is his gentle inclusion into the world by Mr. Lamb. Mr. Lamb gently nudges Derry into accepting the world and its ideologies. He decides to ignore the wishes of his mother to convince Mr. Lamb that he did not reject Mr. Lamb for being lame. Derry is 14 years old. One side of his face has been completely burnt by acid. Before he meets Mr. Lamb, he is introvert. Introvert means a person who does not like to mix with others. He is defiant and scared. Defiant means when he confronts the world and is ready to fight it. He is defensive. He is indulging in self-pity. He is full of bitterness. He suspects affection, even that of his mother. He is pessimistic. A pessimistic person always looks on the negative side of things. And moreover, he is an escapist. Escapist is a person who wants to escape from the realities of life. Derry believes that he is looked down upon by people as an ugly child. That is what he feels people think him to be. He believes that people were either afraid of him or they sympathize with him, because when they talk to him, they avoid looking at his burnt face. In fact, he accepts that he too is afraid of himself. The example of this is Derry's mother, who is overly protective towards him. She doesn't allow him to go out much. She is scared for his future because of the scar. Instead of giving him confidence, she constantly reminds him of his unfortunate image. Thus, Derry has turned out to be a pessimistic, easily irritable and an introvert boy. Results of this negative belief about himself is that he hates people. He has a pessimistic attitude towards life. He gets easily annoyed and irritated. He finds every conversation as negative and threatening and as a comment on his appearance. He believes that the acid not only ate his face, but also his personality and his future. His morale is lost, and so has his will to really live to the fullest. He has isolated himself, and therefore he came to Mr. Lamb's garden as he believed it to be empty. He also believes that nobody loves him and will never become his friend. He feels that the story of the Beauty and the Beast can only happen in books. In real life, nothing changes. He feels that his mother loves him and kisses him because she pities her son. He has a negative outlook towards the world around him. He believes that when people advise him to count his blessings, as he has all his faculties and is not handicapped or lame, they are just words to console him and are not really true. For him, the difficulties in life are burdens. The weeds at the wall of the garden are rubbish for him. In comparison to him, there is Mr. Lamb, who feels that the weeds are as important as fruits and flowers, since they are both living things or growing plants. He grows them especially as a wheat garden. Now, Mr. Lamb was known as Lamy Lamb by the kids of the neighborhood. The reason was that his leg was blown off during the war and he therefore had a thin leg. His characteristics are: he is open-minded, courageous, calm, confident. He celebrates life and loves people. He is very welcoming, optimistic, and positive. He is the owner of the garden and the house. He always keeps the gates of the garden and the house open so that people can enter the garden anytime they want. He lives in a house with no curtains. He doesn't like shutting things up. He likes the light and also the darkness. He also keeps the windows open so that he could hear the wind. He is fond of his crab apples and bees. He is close to nature and enjoys tending his garden. He likes to watch, think, and listen, and he loves to observe the world around him. He has a positive outlook towards life. He says that when people say, "Bees buzz," for him, the bees sing. This means that the buzzing of the bees is irritating for people, but for him, it is very musical. Despite the physical deformity, he has a lively spirit. With his conversation, he is able to influence Derry to think optimistically. It is not important how you appear physically. What is essential is the way you think, react, and how you are from the inside. Mr. Lamb tells Derry that he loves all creatures made by God and that nothing in this world is so worthless that it deserves to be considered as trash. Even weeds have their own value. He tells Derry that all children call him Lamy Lamb, but he does not mind it. He advises Derry to ignore people's comments in a similar way. He also advises him to ignore people's stares, as people will eventually get tired of staring at him. Instead, Derry should focus on the beautiful things in nature, like the crab apples, the weeds, or the spider climbing up its silken web. Derry is critical of his mother because she only kisses him on the good side of the face. Mr. Lamb deals with the negative attitude of this young boy in a positive way and advises him to think of the beautiful objects in the world. When Derry expresses his bitterness due to the negative comments of the people about him, Mr. Lamb advises him indirectly to hear only those things that are worth listening to. Mr. Lamb narrates the incident of a timid man who refused to come out of his house lest he should meet some fatal accident, but he died in his room itself because a picture fell off the wall on his head and killed him. He wants to convey the thought that one cannot change one's destiny. The story makes Derry laugh heartily, and from then on, his attitude towards Mr. Lamb in particular and life in general starts taking a U-turn. Mr. Lamb has an encouraging word for every passive and pessimistic observation of Derry. He reminds Derry of the positive things he has, like strong legs, eyes, ears, tongue, brain, etc., and advises him to do things in such a manner to be better than all the rest. Mr. Lamb gives a new definition of friendship. He says, everybody is your friend. Their name is an insignificant detail. It is not necessary to know that person's details to be his friend. He advises Derry to love all mankind because hatred corrodes us and hurts more than acid. It destroys us spiritually and emotionally. This final advice from Mr. Lamb changes Derry's persona. Derry's problem was that he was over-obsessed with himself. But now, for the first time, he talks about Mr. Lamb and his handicap. He asks Mr. Lamb what would happen if he were on his own and fell from a ladder and broke his neck. He knows his presence in Mr. Lamb's house could help him, but at this stage he is worried about his mother, who must have been waiting for him. Mr. Lamb gives Derry courage to make his own choice and speak up to his mother. Derry becomes more independent and breaks away from being overprotected. It is at this point that we discover Mr. Lamb's isolation and loneliness. Though Mr. Lamb always tries to be hopeful, he knows that people who promise him that they'll come back never do. Therefore, he doesn't expect Derry to return. Derry, for the first time, had the strength to tell his mother that people should not be judged by their appearance. There is a lot more to them. It is very important to remember that the character of mother reflects the harsh perspective of society, which automatically distrusts people who are physically deformed or disabled. Society is easily influenced by rumors and rarely bothers to verify them. Defying his mother's instruction, Derry goes back to the garden, but only to find Mr. Lamb, who has fallen from the ladder on the ground and is perhaps dead. By the end of the play, we find Derry is completely reformed. He is now optimistic. He believes he can lead his life better and change himself. He is more confident. He is now able to stand up to his mother. He desires to conquer the world. He has love for things outside his world. He wants to interact with Mr. Lamb. He wants his own house to be free of curtains and to have a beautiful garden. The play is divided into three scenes. First scene is the conversation between Mr. Lamb and Derry, where Derry undergoes a metamorphosis. Metamorphosis means a huge change. Second scene is Derry's confrontation with his mother. Third scene is Derry's return to Mr. Lamb's garden, where he finds Mr. Lamb has fallen from the ladder and is either unconscious or dead. Both of them have suffered loneliness and ridicule and emotional trauma due to their respective handicaps. Mr. Lamb's age and wisdom have given him a broader perspective of life and helped him to move on. But Derry still has to come to terms with his deformity and the pessimism associated with it. Dedi is drawn towards Mr. Lam because of empathy. Mr. Lam tells Dedi about things that really matter in life. He also tells him things that no one has ever told him before, and Dedi wants to think about those things. It is thus the inspiration and guidance accorded by Mr. Lam to Dedi that keeps the two together. Dedi learns acceptance. Thank you, and do not forget to like, share and subscribe to Renu's Englishpedia for class 12.